We know there's no such thing as a free lunch, especially given the soaring cost of everything right now.
But what about that splash of sauce on the side costing an extra 70 cents, or a bit of butter with your scone at 50 cents? Are you happy to pay for extras or not?
An unwritten rule of hot chips is having sauce on the side. Same with butter on your scone, but is it fair to be charged extra?
Cafes and restaurants buy in bulk at wholesale prices. We bought this wholesale and we're going to run the numbers. A decent dollop like this, around 60 mils. From this 6-litre bottle, you'd get around 100 serves, which for the cafe is $70 when they only paid $18.50. So what's next? A charge for salt and pepper?
And for more on this, we're joined by CEO of the Restaurant Association, Marissa Bidwell. Good to see you, Marissa. $18.50 to keep 100 customers happy with sauce for their chips. It doesn't seem like much. Is it really worth charging extra?
Look, to charge or not to charge, it's the great condiment debate, really, isn't it? We've experienced exponential cost increases across the board for our industry. And while it may not seem like a lot, it really every bit adds up at the end of the day.
Would you say that charging for extras is becoming more common given the rising cost of things?
Look, we asked around actually a few of our members around the country, and it seems to be that a lot of businesses around the country have been doing that for some time. In restaurants, however, as you know, when you look at the menu, you order the dish, everything comes that sort of outlined on the menu. So it's a bit different in a restaurant, you know. But if you were had as part of your meal a beautiful truffle sauce of some kind and you wanted a little bit of extra than what the chef had portioned for the dish, it would be reasonably common to probably be charged for that. Whereas if you're in a fish and chip shop, you know, or a bakery, apparently, they've been charging extra for that for some time. So it doesn't seem like it's a new thing at all.
So just how tough is business for cafe and restaurant owners at the moment, Marissa?
Look, as I mentioned before, we have seen some pretty steep increases across the board. 12% alone in food costs. And I know the people at home will be experiencing this as well. But the same is true for our businesses as well. All of those sort of raw ingredients, all of that has gone up as well. So it does put pressure on businesses, unfortunately.
Just going back to the extras for a moment, are restaurants and cafes who charge extra for things like butter and soy sauce and tomato sauce and these sorts of things at risk of putting people off dining out or going to their establishment?
Look, I really hope not. As I said before, many of our businesses, some of them will incorporate those extra costs into the menu price altogether, whereas some might choose to adopt a user pays type system where if you do ask for sauce to go with your chips, that maybe you would be charged for it. And in other occasions, you may not. So if you don't like sauce on your chips, you may actually be saving money in the end.
Should they be upfront about adding on the cost of extras?
Absolutely. I think that's really, really important, is to be really clear about what is being charged for. That's something we absolutely say to our members at the Restaurant Association. Make sure that it's very clear what's being charged for, so there's no surprises when people come to pay at the end of the day or the evening.
Thanks, Marissa. Nice to see you. Have a great weekend.
Wonderful. Thanks for having me.